With a new single storming up the charts and a debut album waiting in the wings, X Factor sensation Amelia Lily has had little chance to catch her breath since turning 18. We had a chat with the Middlesbrough-born star to find out about her latest single, Shut Up and Give Me Whatever You Got, as well as her plans for the album and what life is really like for the young celebrity.
I think with this song, I think that it's got a lot more attitude in there. I think it's a little bit older. And also I think that it's quite a statement song, this one. It's a lot heavier and a lot bigger. And it's kind of a little bit of girl power in there as well, kind of like, don't mess with me. I actually came up with the video, so I was really pleased, obviously, that people, wanted to work with my ideas. So it was great, and I'm really pleased with the outcome. Near the Six is out. Yeah, it's going really well. I've been working on the album for about a year and a half now. And obviously we're at that stage now where we're coming to final touches and mastering the tracks. It's been really fun, and I feel like I was 17 when I started the album. I'm 18 now. I feel like I've kind of like grown up throughout the album, and you can hear the kind of mature side to Amelia on some of the ballads, and you hear the young fun, 18-year-old Amelia on some of the tracks as well. So it's nice to kind of have like that, that diverse range on the album of sound.
And last time I saw you, you visited the Winn's head office. I remember Lauren, the little girl that won the meet and greet competition, came up with a rather novel idea for a charity fundraiser. What was your thoughts on Lauren and a fundraiser idea and effort on that day?
I thought I was really overwhelmed by that little girl. The fact that she what she's going to do for it, for the charity. I think it's absolutely amazing that I don't think I would have the guts to do that. So she really inspired me, and I thought she was she was just a great little kid, and I absolutely loved her. I'm not a typical 18-year-old. I'm working 24/7 and, living my dream, really. But it's fun, it's nice to kind of say when people say, oh, how old are you? I'm 18, I'm not 17 anymore.
The driving side of things, is any further progress with that? Have you passed yet, or how are you getting on with that?
So I've only done 15 hours driving and haven't done any this year yet, but hopefully I'll pass at some point. It's a beautiful car, and I'm so happy that I got it. It's sad that I can't drive it yet, but unfortunately I've got a busy schedule, so I always tend to reply to my fans as much as I can. I actually did a Skype chat with loads of them last night. I'm really dedicated to them, and they are with me as well. And, I feel like they got me to where I want to be, so I have to give as much back to them as possible, so I absolutely love them.
I know that you're very active on social media. Have you found it, a useful tool for promotion of your music, like your last single and the recent one?
Yeah, I'm not a massive fan of like social network sites. I think that it's like an invasion of privacy. But I think that you can make it, you can keep your personal life to yourself, if you know what I mean. You just don't post about things that you're doing 24/7. But it is great, obviously, for promo for singles, interaction with the fans, and all the supporters as well. And everyone's got Twitter, so it's a great way of kind of like getting in touch with people and etc. Really, the most inspirational fan story was I was leaving a gig one time, and we were literally like, we were in this car and trying to get out of this crowd of like 4,000 people, and this one girl was just like absolutely devastated that I didn't stop for her. But I couldn't stop for anyone because there was so many people, like it would have got out of hand if I'd stopped. So we kind of had to just go, but this girl looks like she was absolutely devastated, and I hate it if I see someone who's just absolutely beside themselves. So I made the car stop, and I said, look, please let me stop this girl. And actually, when she came up to the window, she was a type 1 diabetic like myself. And out of all the people I could have stopped for, why was it her? Like, why did I look at her? I found it really inspiring. And she was like, you don't understand how much you've inspired me, to still do what I want to do in life. even though I'm a diabetic. And stories like that, you know, make me more determined. And it's that's kind of what keeps me going through all this tiredness. And, you know, when I hear those stories, I think, yeah, I'm doing it for you guys just as much as myself.
The X Factor, you know, how useful do you think it is as a launch pad for those who want to get into the music industry? You know, if you had your time again, would you go down that route, do you think?
At the time, no. Like, I was completely never, ever thought I'd audition for it. I never really believed in myself. But I mainly did it because my dad kept encouraging me, and I was like, you know what, I'm just going to do it for him just to shut him up. But you can quite, I think you can kind of surprise yourself at how far you can get if you really put your mind to it. And the further I got in the competition, the more determined and the more I wanted it. So I think it's so hard, you know, for people to get in the music industry nowadays. But I do think the X Factor does give you a great platform, you know. So it's hard, but I'm not going to lie. Like, you know, you either fall really lucky and you get into it, or unfortunately not everyone does. But I felt lucky, and, you know, it's got me to where I want to be, and I'm really grateful for that.
Amelia, what was your biggest musical inspiration, would you say?
Pink. Yeah, she was. I've listened to her since I was about 8 years old, 7 years old, and, like, literally, like, she... I just always had this thing. Like, I always thought that she was individual. She wasn't just a typical pop princess, you know. She had a bit of edge about her, and I think that's why I still love her to this day, really. I struggle to get home, obviously, you know, because I am based down London and I'm up and down the country all the time, so it's hard to get home. But what I miss about home is, you know, that I can just kind of chill out, you know, on my down days. I feel a lot more chilled when I'm up there. I think London's really busy and you always feel like you're working. But yeah, I miss the people.